good graphics like that are only obtained after hours of painstaking and detailed work. It's a sad reflection upon the progress of computer technology that getting pictures on a screen still largely relies upon the same skills as embroidery or weaving. And the problems are just the same. On a home micro, you can't even get perfectly straight lines in some positions. And all circles are wobbly. If I magnify this one, then you can see why. Even a circle is made up of lots and lots of little blocks. So you see, we've come to expect good pictures, Westerns even, from a machine inherently incapable of producing either. Indeed, I found myself saying that those spindly figures wandering about the screen in that most excellent of adventure games, Valhalla, were good graphics. But what I really meant was that the authors of Valhalla, Legend Software, had achieved a remarkable feat of programming. Here, Tyre attacks Hell, and we can't wait and see what happens. But fortunately, you don't need to be a programmer to have fun with computer graphics. This pad I was using a moment ago is the Koala Pad, an American product distributed in the UK by Softcell. It's one of the most exciting extras you can plug into a home micro. At the moment, there are versions for Commodore 64, VIC-20, Atari and Apple computers. The Commodore 64 version costs about £85 and includes the excellent software which you see here running on an Apple. But the Commodore 64 version comes on a plug-in cartridge, so you don't need a disk drive to be able to use it. Koala Pad completely eliminates the ridiculous QWERTY keyboard, and since two buttons and a pencil are all that's required to operate it, even very young children can use it. Just a finger is enough, but then you need to press quite hard. A pencil is more precise. It's easy to plug in, reliable in use, and already there are several pieces of software to use with it. You can either colour in pictures, which you can buy separately, these are two of the packs, or you can do your own thing as I was doing just then. Rolf Harris, watch out. For owners of the BBC Micro, the nearest available equivalent to the Koala Pad is the British Micro GraphPad system. For about £120, you get the GraphPad itself and a special pen. Now, please forgive the drawing, but I'm going to do it freehand, and I'm not Picasso. Well, don't know, it's rather good, actually. For owners of the Spectrum and ZX81, there's the RD Digital Tracer. You have to provide your own wooden mounting board and screw the tracer to it. Just as with the graph pad, you only get the one drawing package, whereas with the Koala Pad, there are several. But for all its simplicity, it is rather good. And if your budget won't run to £120 for a graph pad, there's a version of this tracer for the BBC Micro at £70. Well, another masterpiece successfully completed.